How are you?
Do you know what? I've come so far since the last time I was here, and I can't believe I was hiding it so well, how low I was, what a rut I was in.
You see, you thought you were hiding it, but you were among friends and we were all really worried about you.
Oh, no, I've come such a long way. I mean, when was the last time I was on? I think I was crying about my mum.
It was January you're on. Obviously,
oh, my God. Obviously,
about your mum, everything else that was going on in your life.
God, I don't even know where to begin. It's really been tough. And like I say, I've got rid of a lot of people in my life around me. I've just come out from such a bad place.
Well, if you're saying you don't even know where to begin, let's go back, obviously, to January. You weren't going out, you didn't want to see your friends, you didn't want to ride your beloved horses, so you went to the doctors and he's put you on tablets to try and sort of help you through this
time. Yeah, it's called Estranoplan. I was on something similar. It's quite a common one. There might be people in here who's on Estranoplan. And when I had postnatal depression with Junior, I was on one called Sitranoplan.
OK.
Really, I just felt I needed it. I just wasn't myself. I wasn't the happy me.
Yeah.
I would want a drink to block things out. I was in a relationship where I felt selfless, that I wasn't worth anything. I felt worthless. I was manipulated into a situation where I felt I wasn't in control. I've been banned from driving and being in the country. I couldn't take my kids to school. Mm. And yet, like with Kieran, I caught him cheating again, but obviously, the show's on, and, well, he's been with three people since the nanny.
And you've spoken before on the programme that Kieran has a sex addiction. Is this something that you still believe is the case?
I don't believe he's got sex addiction at all. And then watching that back, it doesn't make me angry. I just think, oh, what was I doing? Because he wasn't constantly having therapy. He went about four times. But, you know, it is what it is. I tried paying for therapy when I caught him the first time. I mean, I was with him 5 years. You're seeing the show. There wasn't even 6 months of 1 year he was faithful to me. He just hasn't got sex addiction. I don't know what it is he's got, but I'm so glad I'm out of it. I just, when I look back, I can't believe I was in that.
Yeah.
Why do you think, you know, like some women have the rule, I personally, like one strike and you're out. Not once, not twice, three times. Why do you think you've kept forgiving him over and over? What was the reason?
It's about seven times now, you're seeing the show. I don't know, I was manipulated into a situation where I felt it was if I was the one, the reason why he was doing it.
Yeah.
I think because he did everything, he'd make me feel that I couldn't do anything. Like,
what respect, like, looking after the kids and doing
like, he'd cook, he'd do everything and made me feel worthless. And it'd be like, without me, you wouldn't be able to do anything, you know? And but now he's gone, it's like, well, I am. I'm that powerful woman, that independent woman. I've just got out of a bad situation, you know. A lot happened to me, like with my mum.
Yeah. How is your mum?
She had a heart operation a couple of weeks ago. I know she was on the show. Yeah. I was proud of her for doing that. But no, she's... Yeah, she has deteriorated a lot more. I can hear it in her breathing. She's slowed down.
Mm.
Having the op that she had, they... basically, her heart was 80% blocked and she never knew. And they said, we don't know how you didn't have a heart attack and die. So that's drama, but you know, we're all upbeat. We're upbeat with my mum.
Is she recovering well from the operation?
Yeah, I was with her yesterday. We were looking at electric bikes yesterday.
Oh, she's always on the go.
But yeah, I'm just glad I'm out of that situation. And it's only through speaking up and having the guts to go to the doctors. And I just thought, I can't lie to people around me anymore. I have to be honest to people. Because when I'd split with Kieran, he wouldn't leave the house. And I didn't want to go home, even though I wanted to see my kids. I just didn't want to argue.
Well, do you know, I think one of the great things, obviously, about this show is we are incredibly open about all of our experiences. And I think, you know, there's lots of what you're saying that many people at home can appreciate. It's difficult going through any kind of breakup, no matter what the reasons are. You talk about drama. You also had yet another kidnap attempt on Harvey.
Yeah, in the past 6 months, there was one for Essex. Scotland Yard got in touch again. I thought, is this another joke? But it wasn't. It started off with an email, £50,000 ransom, and if not, they were going to find Harvey, cut him up, slash him if I didn't pay this money. So the police found the address, and it was just a woman that lived there. We don't know if it was a vendetta or vendetta, whatever you say.
Is that since? I'm sorry, is that since the hijacking in South Africa or before?
That's during it. This is all at the same time.
Right, OK.
So obviously,
what
then
happens to people when they do? I mean, was
it was a page you go. They tracked back the email, and it was just they couldn't trace it back to anyone. So they've
thankfully
now got that
one.
That's closed. We haven't had any more emails from them.
Okay.
So yeah, that at the same
time, one thing after another.
Then the hijack thing. I don't know if you'll talk about that.
Well, very quickly, you were filming while you were in South Africa and your car got hijacked, and which was an incredibly stressful situation. And again, thankfully, everybody came out of that. Everyone thought it was
just to promote the show, but we was all held at gunpoint, threatening to kill us. No, the police don't know why they didn't kill us, because in South Africa, that's what they do.
Yeah. Have you had any... I mean, that is such a trauma, Katie, to have been in that situation. Have you spoke to anyone properly?
Oh, yeah, we're all having therapy for it, because... even now when I'm in the car, I'm like that, thinking if someone's going to come up to the window.
But do you think, Katie, now, like, well, obviously, you know, drinking, I can relate to that when my mum got ill. Like, do you think you maybe be self-medicating? Because I know I did.
Oh, it is. It's until the escapism.
Of course it is.
100%.
It numbs it.
Because I went to the doctors thinking, am I losing the plot here? Yeah. Like, because I just didn't feel like me. And I explained, I was honest to the doctor. If you can't be honest to the doctor, yeah. who can you be honest to? And they totally understood, because they knew the stresses I was on. Yeah. And they said it's called escapism. I was a short-term case, not a long-term.
Yeah.
Because they said sometimes when they get people that come in there, they don't know why they're depressed or, you know.
Yeah. I think it's fairly obvious. But I have reasons to be. In your case. I mean, we're here now and we're so happy that you are here.
Yeah, so am I.